invited into our home, into our heart. Trust in the path and you'll find the answers you seek. Even those who fight against us seek salvation. You're proof of that. We all need guidance in times like these.
So we must be strong. We must be vigilant.
Now you'll see. Now you'll truly understand.
Because those on the outside will see what we have built here together in our new Eden. Love. And they will come, and they will try to take from us all that we have built.
You judge me, you judge us, the things that we have done. People say that I'm crazy, but when you wake up in the morning, you look at the same news that I do.
This is the world? This is the world we built for our children? Communities being torn apart? Walls being erected because leaders are too impotent to act? Bullies are too addled to lead righteously?
I did not ask for this.
We are hurtling towards our destruction and no one is willing to do anything about it. I can see that. You can see. But we are not crazy. So what are we supposed to do? We just sit back and await the inevitable?
I claim to be a perfect man. I saw what was coming, and I chose to act, to lead, because society is broken. And the only way forward is to go back to the way things once were. Innocent and pure, so safe and protected in our garden. I can save you.
Jesus Christ, you scared the shit out of us.
Hey, Sheriff. Couple didn't make it back. Boys said...
Anybody grab Burke?
Grady, supposedly, but...
Well, where the hell's Grady?
Ah, Jesus. Now, you just relax. Lie back. I'll see you in the morning.
You come out of the bliss too fast. Shit's liable to scramble your fucking brains.
We need to conserve our I told the sheriff. There's no telling how long this will take to resolve.
I mean, if that's your thing, of course, I don't mean to assume, you know. You know what, I'll just stop talking and head out now. Y'all notice how they're rolling out.
I love this song.
Good job, Rook. That fly shop's practically a historical monument at this point. Good to see it back in the right hands.
Looks like you made a friend.
Hey, partner, it's me.
Couldn't have done it without
me. Listen up. Zip came by again last night, foaming at the freaking mouth about
I got a job for any volunteers. Hey, can you help me out? It looks like the Peggy's kept a bunch of angels locked in the basement. I don't know how many they got down there, but I ain't going near them. I've seen one too many angels that were once my friends. Listen, we need to secure this whole area. That means the basement, too. You'd be doing me a big favor if you marched down there and cleaned them out.
Send him on his way. Don't let him get in your head.
This is fantastic. There's new stuff added all the time.
You don't want to get stuck.
Nothing more loyal than a good dog.
I'm gonna cover my ass while I meander.
Like one of them rapping music videos. Super flossy, all kinds of asses bouncing at me, money,
bet if you built a motel or something here, you could get fishing tours.
We're keeping these digs thanks to you.
We kept our home base thanks to you.
Deputy people been talking.
Thanks for helping. It's not much, but it's ours now.
They should just outlaw fishing.
That's it, man back! I'm gonna show you the
best. Oh shit, that fish! Rolling out!
Cover my ass while I meander.
It's me, I'm moving!
Them beauties pack more punch than a bull in heat.
commander.
After that, you could have zombie on you. Well, I'm just saying, I'm glad I carried an extra pair of underwear in my pocket. Semi-clean, thank you.
Didn't think those assholes would come back so soon. Well, slap my tits and call me Shirley. You made it just in time for all the fun. And you brought Tulip back in one piece. Now, I always keep my word. So, if you need a pilot who can shoot the dick off a gopher from 50 feet in the air, I'm your gal. You call me, anytime. Except around sunset. Xander likes to do yoga around then, and I like to watch. You ain't lived until you seen that ass and downward-facing dog. Anyways, thanks again, hon. I owe ya. Ooh, we're being sneaky.
Sorry, Auntie. No time for catching up. We're going silent. Going for a stroll. Cover me.
Adelaide Drummond. She's one hell of a firecracker. Good with a gun, and she'll always bring that chopper along with her. Not a bad addition to the group, Deputy.
Can we talk, man? Can you believe what they're doing? Bliss is spewing everywhere. It's toxic shit that those Eden's Gate Bros are shipping everywhere, man. That stuff gets in the river, and it's a toxicity tonic. See those big green containers? They're full of Bliss, and the Peggies are shipping them somewhere important. We need to...
Holy cow! You're gonna have a lot of brains today!
Taking a different position.
Go now!
By skin of my teeth that time.
Bliss, man. That junk. So anyways, like, let's you and me have a powwow. Cool. So, that stuff gets in the river and it's a toxicity tonic. See those big green containers? They're full of Bliss and the Peggies are shipping them somewhere important. We need to find where and destroy them. My life coach says to break problems into bite-sized pieces. So step one. I know about a Peggy laptop that'll help us track down these containers. Once we find them, we blast them. Whoop!
Thank you.
trouble nearby.
I'm getting my shuffle on over here. Laptop's gonna connect to the GPS on their boats. Smart, right? So, like, find the computer, find the boats, then we find their containers. Then you blast them to dust. You!
Watch me,
perspective is always something else.
Guess you don't have to be gentle. You have no respect for the dead.
Okay, I got a GPS lock. Now we can track those boats. First thing, dude, you need to take to the skies and follow that signal. They got a helipad right near that gas station. Go snag what's there and get that eagle's eye view.
Cover my ass while I'm in.
glad our cougars got you out.
That got hairier than a dog's belly. Thank goodness you helped.
Never wore a seatbelt before, not about to start now.
Dude, Herc is on his way.
We need to hold this place. These Peggies are gonna want their co-op back. Trust me, they're like Uber him.
That order.
old mining place. They're gonna have C4 and explosives all over. Perfect for blasting bliss containers, right?
You should figure what
you're doing. Grab some
trees over
there. Good idea.
Deputy, I gotta tell you, I didn't think we'd ever get this far. But you're taking this fight to Faith, and she knows she's losing. So keep doing what you're doing. And don't forget about Burke. If you see that Marshal wandering around out there, you grab him, Rook. We gotta get him out of that bliss. White Horse out.
I see you, dude. Don't go doing anything I wouldn't do.
I can see the light at the end of the tunnel with this place. Just knock out some more shit, kill these strung-up motherfuckers, and move on.
Whoa, wait, you're new. Hey, you want to work in a movie? Of course you do. You are the solution to all my problems. Classic tale, a small town nobody, you, arrives just in time to save world-renowned auteur Guy Marvel. Yours truly. My movie, my masterpiece, is 4 fucking years in the making, and I will not have it derailed by these fucking plebes with no cinematic vision. You know how many fucking awards Blood Dragon 3 is gonna win if we shoot this fucker correctly? All of them! except this entire stretch of flyover country is a 160 decibel noise factory, and I need absolute fucking silence for this scene! Be the hero, Big Shot. My first AD will fill you in. I need to contemplate my own genius for a bit.
You're right on time. Listen, I'm not the first AD, I'm just the sound guy, Dean. Guy fired the first AD after he refused to use live ammunition on cows. Now his genius idea is to shoot a scene like a silent film, only using sound. So, you can probably figure out how well that's going. Noise? In the wilds of Montana? Go figure. This place is loud as fuck. Your job is to kill the sound, and I mean kill it. You hear that horn? It's shit like that we gotta shut down. Go kill the noise, whatever it takes.
I never thought I'd be a freedom fighter.
You hear that horn? Go get him, Hotshot.
Fight in jail must be rough.
I'm getting my shuffle on over here. We got some targets!
your ass back here. I think Guy wants to make out with you.
What is that? Is that the sound of silence? You got a natural talent, kid. Those pussies back in Hollywood could learn a little something from you. The ferocity you showed! Intense, frightening! You made me shit my pants a little, but I liked it. Now I can finally spray my magic all over this film! Blood Dragon 3 will be a masterpiece! Seriously, it has to be. I can't go back to working on shit like Far Cry! I'd rather put my balls in a vice and listen to everyone with their fucking opinions about world building and player motivation and believability. Oh, I'll kill myself, I swear to fucking God. Oh, and I wasn't kidding before. Closed set. Get the fuck out of here.
My great-grandma used to work here. Didn't the job kill her? Wages are pretty good shit, thanks.
I'm getting myself blown over here!
Those who walk the path do so because it is their choice. Who are you to stop them?
Get from above.
These pilgrims cease. Do not interfere with them again.
Target visual.
Get ready for it!
Hot Spring Hotel, Rook. We'll be able to use that old building as a place of shelter, even though most folks around here would think twice. You know, some say that place is haunted. But I never much bought into that kind of malarkey. Anyway, keep up the good work, Rook.
You're not gonna believe me? There's a crazy-ass bear in Lydia's cave. The cult used that drug to try and turn it into some kind of weaponized super bear. Didn't work. And it got loose. It's nasty as all get out and tough. We sent a bunch of people to kill it, but none of them came back. I'm hoping you got what it takes to get rid of that sucker. Please, before it kills more people.
Ever played.
Nothing better than a warm fire and dog breath. We almost lost the outpost.
Get my move on.
Damn it! Watch my shit!
I'm a bust except for dancing, it's escaping.
Bless.
Don't you understand what we're trying to build? Or do you just not care? I watch you run this way and that, inflicting violence on those who wish no harm upon you. They're at peace here. They want to be here. I know you have your doubts. But this is the only way the story ends. Nothing you can do can change that. Your friends on the outside, they're controlled by fear. They don't understand. But he does. He'll show you.
Hey, Rook. Come on. Come on, it's okay. I know you're here to take me back. It's okay. She knows. Everybody knows. You think you're doing the right thing. You think I need to be rescued. But I don't. I don't want to go back. Ever. Have you ever stopped and looked at how your life's turned out? I mean, what you've actually done with it, you know? We're told we can be anything, right? A famous singer, Hall of Famer, movie star. We're all gonna be a success, Rook. But no, that's just not true. We live mundane lives, just doing what someone else tells us to do. Day after day. Everybody thinks they have free will, but come on, when's the last time you did something that wasn't required? Demanded? Nah, Rook. We don't live our lives. We live theirs. And we think we have free will. But that is just a lie. An illusion. Oh, man. I am so done with that. I am done with being the yes man. I am done with being the errand boy. And I am done with being the garbage collector. I am so done. Because if that is real life, then what is the point? This place gave me the chance to become something I thought I could never be. Happy. And in the end, Rook, isn't that the only thing that really matters? Happiness.
Don't trust the Bliss. You need to get the Marshal. Now's the time. Don't let the Marshal get through those gates. Get the Marshal now. Rook, you need to save him.
Leave him alone! Leave him alone!
You're doing great.
Right, Tracy, get that syringe over here! Oh, calm down, calm down. All right, look at me. Look at me.
No, no, John! No!
Okay, it's just to take the edge off.
No, no drugs. Put your guns down.
You just can't come out of the Blitz clean.
I can. I can.
Sheriff.
All right.
Please.
All right.
I'm not scrambled.
All right.
Stay away from me.
All right, just lay down.
Stand up.
You shouldn't have brought him here.
Tracy.
Fuck you, Tracy. I said this was a bad idea. I said it from the very beginning. You don't know her. How she digs inside your head. Don't trust him.
I'll go talk to her.
She's gonna come back on you, kid.
We're up and down. I saw.
Need be ready.
Bright as anything. Slowly but surely, we're bringing some reality back to this place.
I'm gonna strafe these sinners. is coming in.
Thank you for saving me. My name is Dr. Charles Lindsay. I'm part of a group holdup south of here at the old jail. Faith and her angels have been trying to get to us for days. I was out here looking for a way to stop them when the cult took me. I think I found a way to bait the angels, but the ingredients for the bait are in my bag and the cult food in the pond. And I can't swim. I know who can't swim, but I need you to go get it for me.
Thank you.
might have a fighting chance against Joseph Seed's brain-dead goons now. Sorry, my name's Charles. Everyone calls me Doc, but I'm not that kind of doctor. I'm a veterinarian, but right now I guess I'm the resident ER doctor. Stitching up bullet wounds is a lot different than delivering cabs, that's for goddamn sure. Sorry, doesn't matter. Here's the deal. I stumbled on something that seems to attract the angels, which means we could herd them. I went out to try a field test, but things went sideways. Fucking cult. I'm missing ingredients, and if I stay out here, I'm just gonna wind up dead. I have to get back to the prison. Can you help me? I've got the list of stuff I still need. If you could find them, we may actually have a chance at surviving.
Yeah, my daddy calls this place Devil's Own Asshole because it smells so bad. Look, Boomer's a cute dog and all, but he's a little fresh. You know what I mean? I mean, maybe a bad, but maybe you.
The entire crew walked out. They left! And you know what? Fuck up! Same thing happened to Coppola, and look where he is now! We are the future of modern cinema. When we're up on that podium next year, all of those fuckers will regret doubting us! Picture this, the most epic, badass fight sequence ever shot on a micro budget, screaming zombies, blood, explosions, but with heart. Here's the scene. They killed your mentally disabled, blind labradoodle puppy, so you go apeshit! We're talking a baseball batting, headshotting, death from above-ing, explosive, fiery, bloody, pièce de résistance! Only snag, I blew the budget on these lights, so we can't afford extras. But, problem solved, we dip into the local talent pool, specifically those bald, brainless space cadets wandering around. Find some of those droolers outside and lead them back here so I can start rolling. I'll direct you through the action, so let's go, baby. Guerrilla filmmaking!
Time is money, baby! Find those angels and bring them here! First position!
Thank you.
blood, guts, gore, and not one pixel of CGI! That is how it's done!
I got to get over there.
It's in the can! Waiting for the world's adulation. That's a wrap! Oh my god, we did it! Fuck! I marvel at this reaction.